So that's what the lesson is. We should read the scriptures, we should do mantras every day. And at a material level, you know that voice inside. And at a spiritual level, you understand that even if I have understood that voice, enough of it. One day the game has to stop. So these are the two lessons which Saturn wants to teach us. This is what I think.
Yeah. So I have a small question here. As you say, Saturn pinches you to hold the ground of your material world, right?
Yes.
So by this, it is that mean that it puts us in such situations that our responsibilities gets increased, or
see,
we have to handle.
Saturn forces you to make a decision.
Yeah.
And when you make a decision, you have to accept responsibility.
True.
Like, for example, before you get married, you have a lot of freedom and opportunity, right? Or maybe I can marry him, him, her, whoever, man or woman.
True.
But once you decide, then then there is no
free will. Yeah.
It's like, and it's very tough to decide. Marriage or anything else. Marriage is what? Like, why marriage? It's so difficult to decide the partner because you stay with that person, right, for the next 30 years, 40 years, 50 years.
True.
Together, 24 hours.
True.
So if that person is having challenges, major challenges, fundamental problems, then your life will be ruined if you stay with that person. So that is why it's very difficult to make the decision. Who do I end up marrying? Of course, I mean, the people who decide very easily sometimes, depending on their karma.
Yeah.
But sometimes after you decide, the problem comes.
True.
And that is why there was, when I came to Germany here, in my dormitory, there was a German girl. She was very young, you know, around 18 years.
Okay.
So she saw my face and she said, "Oh, you look like Dubi from India." I'm like, "Yeah, yeah, I'm from India." And she said, "I have a question, you know, for in people who know about India and Indian culture. I heard that you have some system of horoscope matching. You know, you give points to this boy, this girl, you know, then you decide which will be better, he or she."
Yeah.
Then I said, "Well, yeah, that system is there, compatibility matching." And then she said, "But don't you think it's very funny, you know, to put people into categories like this point-wise? Okay, we both 20 points, you and 25 points. Don't you think it's very inhuman, or it's like making people into machines like that?" Of course, I mean, she doesn't know what the ethos of the Vedas and the scriptures is. And so I cannot blame her for thinking like that. But then by that time, I was not doing many consultations, of course. But I was still, you know, kind of looking at charts and talking to people regarding all this. So then I told her that, well, yeah, it looks a bit funny in the periphery that why we are doing all this. But the only difference between we Indians and you Germans, there's only one difference, you know. Both of them will do matching.
Mm-hmm.
But the only difference is we do it before and you do it after.
True.
So many people I get messages from, especially from the Western countries. "Oh, we are in a relationship. Can you tell us we will have a future or not?" So basically, that's the same thing they are doing, which Indians do before the marriage. Now, I'm not saying it's good or bad. Right. I'm saying that's a very difficult decision. So that's one example that you have a freedom to choose who you want to marry. But once you decide, then you have to take responsibility. You cannot say, "Oh, it's not working, so we'll find somebody else." At least in the scriptural context, that's not how it works. So that is what is the meaning when I say, you know, that there's a pinch. Is it understood?
Okay. Yeah, perfectly understood. So let's move ahead. This is the last question of our interview, and I think it is the most awaited one. So okay. You see, everyone is so fearful of Saturn Sade Sati, right? So how to let go of this fear, and if you could give any advice or remedies, what would you like to tell people?
Well, I would say you may fear it, but healthy fear is good.